Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to hour number two of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Wrapping up this week here on this early Friday morning. So if you're tuned in out there and listening, greatly appreciate you ending the week with That Business Show, a show with a positive message as we talk to the many different community leaders, entrepreneurs, and political leaders from in and around the Tampa Bay community. I know a lot of negativity on the airwaves, and unfortunately just another tragic event just recently heard about again this morning up there in down there in Dallas, I should say. So again, just an unfortunate situation, and we wish the families of all the victims out there their best, sending our prayers that way. So again, just another senseless tragedy. But if you're tuned in to me and not that nonsense that goes on out there, I greatly appreciate you taking a break from all that. That's what this show works to do, is bring positivity to the community each and every morning by talking to our different business owners and leaders. Help support the show. A number of ways you can do that. You can contribute as a guest. We do welcome in people, you know, anytime for a guest appearance, no charge for that. Just tell me about what it is you'd like to talk about and send me an email, jamie@tampabayradio.com, or use my contact form. Another way to support the program is through membership in the Tampa Bay Business Owners, of which the show is now a partner with. And so by becoming a member, you're helping support the positivity on the airwaves and also yourself in the business community. So it's a win-win solution for both of us. So I encourage you to visit tbbo.org for more information on that. And also our many events that come up. If you're a member, several of them are free. If you're a member of the community, you can also attend by purchasing a ticket over at the website. Big event coming up on July 21st is our Christmas in July. That's available to the entire community. And that'll have 500 to 600 people in attendance. We have vendor booths and sponsors and a lot of good food and drinks brought to us by Mr. Margarita in conjunction with the Tampa Bay Business Journal, both sponsors of the Tampa Bay Business Owners. Tickets available at $29 over at tbbo.org/CIJ, the acronym for Christmas in July. tbbo.org/CIJ, $19 for TBBO members. But get your tickets. It'll be a very fun business social. And we got a graphic of that up on the video stream if you're watching that right now. A picture of Santa Claus holding the tequila bottle.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet Santa. I just hope he isn't too drunk.
You know? Yeah, we had an interesting story about the Santa Claus we will have a person in a Santa Claus suit. The Santa Claus who was in attendance last year went into a diabetic shock at the beginning of the event. And
that's Chris, the story you're going with?
Yeah, that was
it. I don't believe that.
Chris had a scramble. Yeah, Chris had a scramble because he had a medical emergency right at the start of his event, and he was all flustered and stuff. But he worked through that last year, and the gentleman was okay after the event and everything. But yeah, a little bit of a wrench thrown into a major event at the start of last year's Christmas in July.
Maybe hire sober Santa this year.
So again, July 21st, 5 to 8:30 at T. Pepin Center. Pick up tickets, tbbo.org/CIJ. Time to bring in my guest for the first half of today's show. I have Josh Vietti, who is a hip-hop and pop violinist, and you can also learn more about him over at joshvietti.com. Josh, good morning to you.
Good morning. How y'all doing?
Doing good. And I know you're out in California right now. So what is it, like, 5 a.m. out there?
It's 5 a.m. I had to sneak out of my house. I've got a sleeping wife and kids. I did it for you guys.
Well, we greatly appreciate you checking in on this early Friday morning, and even earlier for yourself. So first off, tell us, you're a musician. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yes, sir. So I'm based in Southern California. I've been labeled, if you will, a hip-hop or even pop violinist by shows like Ellen, The Ellen DeGeneres Show, ESPN's The NFL Countdown. I played on Wii TV for a bunch of stuff. But I play a variety of styles other than that, such as jazz, country, gospel, classical music, and I just love music in general.
Do you frolic and dance around like Lindsey Sterling?
I've tried. It's just not nearly as attractive. I will try to tell you that. Lindsey Sterling's got her thing going because she's...
Yeah, she does, like, backflips and stuff on stage.
Yeah, if you're an attractive girl and you can dance, like, you don't even need a violin. So the fact that she plays a violin, I can't compete with that part.
Now, have you ever worked with Lindsey Sterling in the violin business there?
No, I would be honored to. I'm actually a huge fan. I've been following her for years, and at various times, I've tweeted her. She Instagrammed me, like, hey, well, that was cool, but. Yeah, nothing's really happened.
Yeah, I mean, I was turned on to her a few years ago when she was doing the whatever it was, that competition or whatever, where they kind of, you know, castigated her. Yeah. Since she wasn't talented enough. And then
discovered on YouTube.
Yeah, and she really made a name for herself.
She has over 1 billion views on YouTube.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, and I really fell in love with her music and the violin. And now that I've met you, I'm definitely going to be checking out your musicianship and stuff. So I'm very excited about that. But describe your work for me a little bit more and what you do.
Yeah, this hip hop violinist thing.
How do you combine hip hop and violin? Yeah, how does that work?
Well, I'll be honest. So I'm classically trained. I played since I was 4 years old. I grew up in Southern California, but didn't have very much money. But I was fortunate enough to get a violin scholarship when I was 7 years old with Misha Lefkowitz from the Los Angeles Philharmonic. He's one of the best virtuoso violinists in the world from Russia. And I studied with him for 10 years. And that's where I got my formal training for. And so I've been fortunate enough to have been blessed with that foundation. And ironically enough, I went to college, went to Cal State Long Beach here in SoCal. And I wasn't going to pursue music. I didn't want to teach it. And I just kind of got a regular job after school and hated it. And so literally I made a demo for fun and I went out to Santa Monica. Do you know where Santa Monica is?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And set up a little area, illegally found out, and made some really crappy demos that didn't even have a cover on it. And this was like 10 years ago. And in like 10 minutes, I had a huge crowd. I was selling a bunch of CDs like at 10 bucks a piece. I'm like, wow, people actually like this and will pay money for this.
Now, how have you grown as a musician? We hear today about so many people being found on YouTube. Has YouTube impacted your growth as a musician?
Yes. I'll get to that in 1 second. How much time do we got, by the way?
Oh, we've got about another 4 minutes, 5 minutes in this segment, so go right ahead.
So, literally, I was street performing, and I wasn't necessarily doing hip-hop, but I've always mixed beats in with the violin. To my former teacher's dismay, he didn't like anything modern. He likes what I'm doing now, actually. I was actually discovered by a hip-hop artist from New York, and formerly of the Rough Riders, and he invited me into a studio session. And that was my first taste of mixing hip-hop with the violin.
Was that Irv Gotti by chance?
It was not, but this particular rapper was so amazing. The producers were incredible. It was legit. It was like a major label studio session, and I had never done one in my life. He was literally out on the street looking for women and other things, and instead found a white boy playing the violin. So.
Interesting. Go ahead.
Story.
It's a good thing you didn't call it a fiddle, because that would have like totally ruined everything, I think.
Yeah, you guys want to hear The Devil Went Down to Georgia? No.
Hey, I love that song, by the way.
I love that song.
Of course you would, Captain West Virginia.
All right, go ahead, Josh.
So anyway, that's how I fell in love with hip-hop. And then, YouTube has been most of my break, other than some networking. Like, literally my first thing as a street performer, I got cast to play a street performer in an NBA All-Star Game commercial that was narrated by Common. You had LeBron and Wade dunking in it. And that was, like, my first thing. And I've done a bunch of sports stuff, which I'll tell you about in a second. But with YouTube, that's how I got discovered by ESPN. I was in a commercial that aired every Sunday throughout the Super Bowl. And then Chris Berman on The Countdown, if you watch that show, invited me to come on the show, and I played live, and I did a bunch of songs. I think I did 50 Cent's In the Club. I did Got Money by Lil Wayne and a bunch of other like classical things, too.
Interesting. All on the violin with a hip-hop beat. Yeah. So that's how this comes together. Yeah.
It sounds pretty rad, actually.
I got to check this out. Yeah, I haven't had a chance to listen to the soundtracks just yet. We're going to play some of those here in just a moment, though. But before that, so you've played for the likes of Jerry Weintraub, Michael Jordan.
Wiz Khalifa.
And you've worked with a number of national charity events, too. Who are some of the charities and some of the events that you've worked to support?
Okay, I've played for a bunch of charities. All that's correct. Jerry Weintraub, played for him multiple times. For those who don't know, he produced Ocean's 11, Karate Kid. He represented Frank Sinatra, Elvis Presley, and created John Denver. So he was kind of a big deal. Arguably, maybe like the best Asian that ever lived. Michael Jordan, I played for his foundation in Las Vegas. It was for Make-A-Wish Foundation. Got to meet him, take a picture. And I actually opened up for two artists because it was a whole week event. I opened up for Neo. and for Fabulous in Las Vegas, and that was pretty darn incredible. And then got to meet Jordan, so that was just like one of the coolest gigs to date. I have not met Wiz Khalifa. I covered one of his songs.
Okay, that's the See You Again then, correct? That's the name of the song?
Yeah, that's actually a cover that I have on my brand new CD called Play to Win.
Okay.
And I'm a huge Wiz Khalifa fan. And on my last album, Best of Both Worlds, I covered Black and Yellow. And that album's been streamed 5 million times. So something about me covering a Wiz track just always works.
Okay. We actually got a sample of that. And so we're going to put that on the airwaves. So, Connor, if you want to count that down there, because we got to sync it with the live video here. But we're going to play See You Again, which is from his latest album, Play to Win. Go ahead. And wind that down. That's very, very talented. I very like the melody of that, and we also got that up on the live video stream, so that worked out really well. So, Josh, tell us, you know, about, you know, we're talking about how YouTube has impacted you as a musician. So how has it benefited and helped you as a musician?
So YouTube has been how I've gotten most of my major gigs and breaks, and have gotten to open up for some pretty big artists. And also, YouTube is the future for artists. Like, if you're not on there, unless you are, like, a major deal, and even if you are, you should probably still be doing stuff. And growing your channel is just a way to reach out to your fans worldwide and give them, like, a private concert. But also, I've been doing advertisements based on the number of YouTube views I have. Like, I did an ad for New Era Caps, which represents all the caps for Major League Baseball and NFL, because I always wear a cap when I play. And if you look at Lindsey Stirling, like, she's killing it, like, because of YouTube, like, she has a huge career. Like, you said all the stuff on America's Got Talent, but she doesn't need them because she controls her own everything.
Her own content.
Yep. No, yeah, she's like her own manager. Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Yeah, by doing that, like, it's very early over here in the West Coast.
She's also one of the most humble people you'll ever meet.
So let's go ahead, Josh.
I said she's also one of the most humble people you'll ever meet, too, which comes across in her YouTube.
Man, that's real cool. You don't hear that all the time.
Let's take a quick break here. Josh, when we come back from the break, though, we got an original track that we're also going to play by you, which is called Best Things in Life. So we're going to feature that when we come back from the break. So I'm currently talking to Josh Vietti, hip-hop and pop violinist. You can learn more about him at his website. Just got it up and running, as a matter of fact. He said joshvietti.com, and that's V-I-E-T-T-I, joshvietti.com. You're listening to That Business Show, Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
How many times have you said to yourself, I wish there was an app for that? Stop wishing and start making the world better. Turn your brilliant idea into a profitable business by using Popcorn Apps. Their affordable app design will help get your blue sky idea or proven business to the next level at a fraction of the cost of other developers. They will help you get through all the steps needed to make your thoughts become live. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today.
Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is number one, upfront pricing, two, clear deadlines, three, personally available year-round, and number four, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit TaxHappens.com for more information.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right. Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa. Celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let Proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made, well-worn cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at JaegerFlooring.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Tosseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at RickTosseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Tosseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Just some minor delays on the interstates around Tampa Bay. Typical stuff on westbound I-4 near MLK and Orient. Also westbound from the Selma Connector to 275. Veterans Expressway looks really good this morning. Just some minor delays as you enter that construction area near Waters, southbound towards Hillsboro, off the Howard Franklin Bridge. Some minor delays there as well. See traffic problems. Call the injury firm of Abrahamson, New York, Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by SOS Children's Villages. War, poverty, and disaster have left millions of children around the world orphaned, abandoned, alone. When their parents can't be there, SOS Children's Villages is there in 134 countries, including the U.S. To make a difference in a child's life, go to sosusa.org.
Today, mostly sunny and hot with a high 93, the heat index over 100. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 80. Tomorrow, a 20% rain chance, high 92.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. On the phone line with Josh Vietti, hip-hop and pop violinist. You can learn more about him over at joshvietti.com, and he's calling in from California, so it's like 5:30 in the morning over there, so we appreciate that. So Josh, we got another clip here. we want to play here. We got about 5 minutes left, so we want to get to this right away. But best things in life. Anything you can tell about us? Tell us about this before we throw it up.
Yeah, so I wrote this song from scratch in my backyard, just chilling. I've got two small kids, 3 and 5, both boys, just playing. And it was just like the perfect day. And I was like, the best things in life really are free. Like, people stress about money and all this stuff, but it's life is much more than that.
All right.
So I wrote this song and I sent it to my producer, who's Timothy Bailey. He was on tour with Ariana Grande. He's her bass player. He produced this track for me. I wrote it, but then he produced the beat that I sent him, my concept in Europe, bounced it back to me in Southern California. And then I wrote the lyrics, but I'm not a singer. I'm a violinist. So fortunately, I found a guy through a friend of mine in South Carolina. So he sung the song there, bounced me the tracks back to California. And I had it mixed here in Orange County, and it just came out to be pretty awesome.
Right. Yeah, well, if it's anything like the last track, it will be awesome. Because the last one was, man, me and the producer, Connor, we're talking about it. We've never heard nothing as cool as that.
No, definitely pretty tight. I'm a big fan of the violin. So let's go ahead and play Best Things in Life by Josh Vietti with the vocalist Kelvin Armstrong. Connor, go and count it down.
The air I breathe, birds chirping up in the trees. Everywhere I go, I hear a melody. The best things in life are free. I got sandals on my feet, over my head, and food to eat. I got love, and love so sweet. The best things in life are free. The best things in life are free. It ain't about money or fancy things. Well, there are no best things in life are free.
Very cool sample of that piece right there by Josh Vietti. Again, that was Best Things in Life, an original song featuring vocalist Kelvin Armstrong. And so, Josh, how many different tracks have you written now? And I mean, how many albums do you have out? I mean, what's your library like of a production?
So it's pretty extensive, and I write songs every day, and I'm recording new videos weekly. My goal is to do 2 every week, but I'm releasing a video every Monday. For
wow.
Sure.
A musical video every Monday?
Yeah, so if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is Jay,
I'm definitely subscribing.
Vietti, every Monday, a new video will pop up in your feed.
Wow, so it's the channel is Jay Vietti, just your first initial and last name. Okay, so, and you've got a number of millions of views on your videos over there to date as it is. And so that's quite a goal right there, to put up a musical video every Monday. So that kudos to you.
This is a business show, so I might as well throw this out. So I'm actually talking to a film company, but they're one of many film companies that kind of sponsor people on YouTube, and I haven't signed anything yet, so if there's anybody out there, venture capitalists, that want to get in, it's pretty awesome, and the return is crazy from monetization and singles that you sell and the whole wheel. So if you're interested, give me a call.
All right, sounds like a plan. So Josh, we greatly appreciate you checking in on this early Friday morning, and I'm glad I met you. That was some good music. I'm definitely going to subscribe to you on the YouTube channel, and know some of the listeners will too. So if you're ever in the Tampa Bay region, look me up. Josh, go ahead.
Yeah, is it Josh Vietti topic? Is that the YouTube
thing? No, just Jay Vietti.
Just Jay Vietti, okay.
Oh, yeah, I guess that they created that for everybody's got their own topic if you have enough videos on you.
Gotcha.
Oh, okay.
I didn't even post, but my channel is Jay Vietti.
All right. Josh, thank you so much, man. We wish you the best of luck and hope to see you in Tampa here soon.
Have a good one.
All right. And again, Josh Vietti, hip-hop and pop violinist. Learn more about him also at his website, joshvietti.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Hi, I'm Kelly Hamm from Dillmeyer Hamm Consulting. Did you know that one of the biggest challenges that leaders face is getting their employees to be engaged, motivated, and producing amazing business results? At Dillmeyer Hamm Consulting, we'll help you transform your workforce culture from one that might be underperforming, maybe mediocre, to achieving amazing business results. You see, we realize that your workforce culture is equally as important as your business plan and your business strategy. The two must be aligned in order for you to reach your desired business and financial goals.
Hey, Carol.
Hey, Jim.
I just got this this plan that could really help with our process here.
Okay, why don't you just have a seat and let's go over it.
Let us help you transform your workforce culture by leveraging your most important assets, your people. I want to know what's going on in your organization. Let us help you transform your workforce culture. Let's have a conversation.
I feel guilty that I can't always be there when Mom feels stuck at home. She was always there for us. But now she can't get out and I'm not always available to take her places. Someone else needs to help her get around. Then I learned about Home Instead. Now Mom can do what she enjoys because her personal caregiver is there. And I can just be a daughter again.
Are you struggling to care for your loved one? We can help. Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Your day at McDonald's with two Egg McMuffin sandwiches for just $3. Enjoy a delicious Egg McMuffin anytime you want on McDonald's all-day breakfast menu. Grab two Egg McMuffin sandwiches for just $3. Available all day, only at McDonald's.
The 1250 Winds Weather Center forecast. It'll feel like 101 plus this afternoon, a 30% chance of rain going up to 93 under partly cloudy skies. Clearing in 78 tonight, 93 with a 30% rain chance Saturday and Sunday. The UEFA Euro 2016 final Sunday at 2:30 on 1250 WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Great little segment there with Josh Vietti. Yeah. Very excited to have been turned on to his music. We just subscribed over to his YouTube channel. Again, Jay Vietti is that. And also, if you would mind subscribing to our YouTube channel, we would greatly appreciate that, too. Mine may not be as musically entertaining, but a lot of good information on business.
No, it is, because you featured Josh on your show, so it
you
is
know what? Since we got the music and the video clip, though, I wonder if I'm going to get one of those copyright notices and stuff, since it'll pick up his music. Man, to cut
no,
that out.
No, we only played like less than 30 seconds.
All right. Yeah, that's right, because you said you can play up to like a minute inside tracks. And
59 seconds.
59 seconds, and you don't get any copyright issues and stuff. So.
I don't know. YouTube's weird, though, so who knows?
I know. I get it from time to time with just some of the music that you play on the commercial breaks and stuff, so yeah. I can't quite figure it out. But, yeah, very very entertaining. I'm a big fan of the violin, and also Lindsey Stirling, who we touched on a little bit there. If you haven't been turned on to her music, an incredible musician. I think she was on one of those You Got Talent shows or whatever, yeah. And she's a dancing violinist. She bounces all around the stage, and it's very, very entertaining. But when she first came on the scene, she made it to that competition, but they shot her down, saying she was out of tune, the dancing was messing up her playing, and they basically threw out.
And then Shatter Me came out and totally wrecked any yeah. idea they had.
And now she's an internationally known artist and touring across the country, and has tons of millions of views on her YouTube channel.
Yeah, I got to film her at Janice Live.
Did you get to meet her too and talk to her?
Yeah, we interviewed her. Yeah. Matt Lloyd was my boss at the time, and he did the interview. I filmed it, and then we filmed her show afterwards. She's probably one of the nicest people I've ever met on the planet.
Yeah, just
inside and out beautiful.
And another example of how YouTube really helped to grow her as an artist. She was, of course, featured on TV, but did not do well. But it was her YouTube channel that really helped, you know, expose her to the masses and stuff.
And so. By the way, funny judges on said TV show. Her jumping around and doing backflips and whatnot doesn't affect her playing as much as you thought it did, because she was amazing.
So, yeah, look up Lindsey Stirling on YouTube. If you love music, you'll be highly glad that you found her. And I'm a rocker, and I'm not, you know, a lot of times into some of this stuff, but she really incorporates the violin and into some good pieces.
As well as Josh, yeah.
And she's got some good covers, too, like Radioactive that was out a few years ago.
She did the Legend of Zelda song from the old video game, and it's amazing.
Yeah, really creative artist. So check her out, Lindsey
Stirling. Also, the video for that video, or video for that video. That made no sense. But that video for the song, mm-hmm. she's actually dressed as like Link from the video game. And
I haven't seen that one.
Woods.
I have to check that one out.
You got to check it out. It's great.
Definitely checking that out. So, time to bring in my next guest for the program. I have Bob Johnston, CEO of Front Burner. And you can learn more about him throughout the discussion at frontburnerbrands.com. So, Bob, welcome to the program today.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it.
So, Jamie, first off, tell us, what is Front Burner?
Yeah, Front Burner is kind of a management company for our most well-known brand, which is the Melting Pot Restaurants, which started here in Florida in 1975. And I got involved with it at a very young age, 14 years old.
So, yeah, you've worked your way up literally throughout all the ranks, starting as dishwasher.
Yeah,
tell me about this. How did you make it from dishwasher to CEO?
Well, the story goes like this. My two older brothers, Mike and Mark, were involved with the Melting Pot very early on. They were one of the very first franchisees of the Melting Pot restaurant in Tallahassee. I lived there at the time with my mom and dad. I was in high school. There's a few years between me and my older brothers and sister. And they opened up the restaurant. It was my first job. I was one of their first employees. Minimum wage was $1.75 an hour at that time. Yes, I'm dating myself.
Imagine the cheeseburgers you got from McDonald's when the minimum wage. They want $15. They can't even get money.
I think they were a quarter back then. Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, I'm giving away my age, as is my gray hair here. So this was years ago, and I didn't have any intention of staying in the restaurant business as my life's work. But it got into my blood. I found a real passion for hospitality, you know, and that's what we do. You know, it's interesting. Both of your last guests were performers in different ways. And that's kind of what we do at the Melting Pot as well, as we kind of put on a show that involves, you know, visual artistry with the food, but you also get to experience that in a culinary way. So it's very much tied to your last two guests in terms of mm-hmm. being entertainment. We call it eatertainment. So.
Now, you started as a dishwasher, and then tell me through the ranks. What ranks did you move through, and how long have you
sure.
been CEO?
So the way that worked is I started with Mike and Mark, my two brothers, in 79. And a few years later, there were five Melting Pots that were in existence at the time, two of which were owned by my brothers, Mike and Mark. And we came up with the crazy idea to go to the two fellas that started it and ask them if they would be willing to sell us the concept. And that was in 1985. So I was in junior college at the time. And in a span of 6 weeks' time, I dropped out of college. Not something I would recommend to my children, but I did. Got married to the girl who sat behind me, Katina, in psych class. Mm-hmm. And moved to Tampa to start this business with my two brothers. And, you know, the rest is kind of history. We have over 125 Melting Pot restaurants in the United States and also in Canada and Mexico, as well as Saudi Arabia and UAE, and about to open in Qatar. So a very interesting story. And along the way, we birthed this company called Front Burner. And Front Burner is basically the management company where all of our most precious assets, our people, work.
Now, are all the assets under Front Burner, are they all restaurant brands, or is it mostly just the Melting Pot restaurants? What else is involved under Front Burner?
At this time, Front Burner's brand that it manages is the Melting Pot, which has given us this opportunity to look for the next thing to grow, next growth vehicle. So we're actively.
So why wouldn't you call yourself the CEO of the Melting Pot? Why did you create the Front Burner? Because it seems like, you know, now you got a little bit of a disconnect between the brands. Why was that? Is
sure.
it to incorporate other restaurants under this?
We were involved with two other brands that we gave birth to and grew, and we actually spun those off last year and the year before. So that gives us an opportunity to really kind of refocus on the Melting Pot and reinvent that concept, which we're in the process of and very excited about that as we begin to grow the Melting Pot again, not just internationally, but here domestically. Last week, we opened up a brand new Melting Pot in Peninsula, which is Newport News area in Virginia. And next week, we open up one in Mobile, Alabama. So it's fun to be growing the Melting Pot brand again, and we're really excited because
it go through a phase where you weren't in a growth phase and you were just kind of sitting
sure,
with it?
Yeah, sure. I mean, like most businesses in the last 5 years, you know, the economy was maybe a little unkind to us. But we're very, very excited to be in a growth mode now and very excited to be Nation's Restaurant News.
Good. So the economic forecast has opened up to where you're comfortable with the expansion and the growth phase of the business now.
We've actually had, for the last 4 years, we've had positive comp store sales for the Melting Pot. So we're very excited about that. And we've been named by Nation's Restaurant News, which is kind of the Bible mm-hmm. of our industry, as a consumer's top pick. This is a consumer award. A company researches this and selects the top restaurant brands. Last year, we were the number one consumer pick. This year, number two, just behind Cheesecake Factory. So we're really excited about
congratulations on that.
The positive feedback we're getting from our
now
consumers.
You mentioned a couple other brands. Are those still being developed in addition to the Melting Pot? Well, what became of those other brands that you touched on?
What we're doing now, actually, we sold those two brands off. And so what we're doing now is focusing, in addition to the Melting Pot growth, we're focusing in two areas. One is looking for the next growth vehicle. And so this could be a concept which already exists, and we purchase, much like we did back in 1985 with the Melting Pot, right? Mm-hmm. So a concept that is a solid concept, but the operator doesn't really know how to take it from where it currently is and scale it. And that's what we do. That's exactly what we know how to do very well. The other thing that we're doing is kind of sharing what we've learned over the course of the last 30 years with other businesses. So we have a consulting practice through Front Burner where we can help someone who has a concept learn how to perhaps franchise it and scale it itself.
Yeah, there's so many, and I've interviewed a number of restaurant owners on my program, but they have a hard time getting out of that one location. Maybe they get a second location, but I mean, how did you grow something to, you know, hundreds of locations from a restaurant owner standpoint?
Well, that wasn't easy. You know, and I'll tell you that there is this, you know, common misconception that going from one operating restaurant or business to two is twice as hard. Well, it's not twice as hard. It's four times as hard. Scaling a business is very challenging. And our first 10 years, candidly, was really tough. We did grow. We went from the five restaurants when we bought the concept to 19 a decade later.
Did some key relationships help you with the growth phase, or was it just trial and error and trying stuff?
Let's be candid. When we started the franchise business, I was 21 years old. Okay, I had no formal education. Right. I was a dropout from junior college. So everything I learned from everyone I could come in contact with. And that it's still the way I try to operate today. A day doesn't go by where I don't learn something from someone.
But was there one secret or one key relationship that finally was like the aha moment with the expansion phase of your business?
Not a key relationship, but a discovery, absolutely. I mean, after a decade of growing and being met with some level of success, but not what we thought we could achieve, we took a hard look at ourselves and said, what's wrong with the Melting Pot concept that we aren't growing? And the reality was we learned that there was nothing wrong with the Melting Pot concept, but there were some things wrong with us. And we didn't really know what we
said. When you say us, are you talking about the management team? Or are you talking about the staff?
And my two brothers and the management of the company at the time. We really didn't have a clear understanding of what we stood for. So in kind of our aha moment was sitting down and saying, what are the things that we should put first? And we created a list of eight principles and beliefs that we then began to use to guide our decision making. And all of them really focused around two audiences, the consumer, our customer in the restaurant, and our team members. And we put them first. And only then did really the growth begin to happen.
So you didn't make any major changes to the operations of the restaurant, the menus, nothing like that. It was really just putting the consumer and then your staff first and behind these eight principles. These eight principles still guiding the company to this day?
Yeah, actually added two since then. Mm-hmm. And absolutely. I mean, we use it as a platform for everything we do, whether it's coaching and developing people or menu development or considering a new growth vehicle, you know, we turn to our principles first. And the results speak for themselves. First 10 years, we went from 5 to 19 restaurants. The second 10 years of our growth, we went from 19 to well over 100.
Mm-hmm.
And as you say, same concept, just operated better because we had a clear vision and understanding of who we
do
are.
Do you make the principles public knowledge, or is that a trade secret?
Yeah, in fact, if you want to go to Front Burner Brands, that's plural, .com, you can learn a little bit about our parent company, Front Burner, and employment opportunities, and the principles of Front Burner are listed right there.
I'm definitely going to review that. I'm definitely interested in the growth of a business. That's just something that fascinates me, how somebody can take something and grow it into something amazing, and then other people have something, but they can't grow it, but it's so good at that local level. And so,
I'm curious to hear the principles. I imagine it's something like crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and hear the lamentations of the women.
I'll definitely go to review them, and maybe we'll talk about them when we come back to a break. I don't know, but let's take a quick break here. We're currently talking to Bob Johnston, CEO of Front Burner, which is the parent company of the Melting Pot brands, which are known across the country. Learn more about him at frontburnerbrands.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
Attention medical professionals. Have you heard that Tampa Bay will become the first certified wellness district in the country? Thanks to Jeff Fenech's revitalization of Channelside, the Doctor Whisperer wants to streamline your efforts in preparation. So when you're ready to ignite your practice, use the Doctor Whisperer's public relations expertise to spread the word. Use the Doctor Whisperer to motivate your staff. And use the Doctor Whisperer to recruit and secure leaders within your practice. Call the Doctor Whisperer today at 727-420-2481 or visit thedoctorwhisperer.com, where they write your prescription for success.
Who doesn't have a smartphone these days? And of course, there's an app for everything. Well, almost everything. That's why the folks at Popcorn Apps started developing mobile applications. They saw people like you with genius ideas unable to make those thoughts a reality. They develop applications for tens of thousands of dollars less than you'll find anywhere else and will turn your idea into a reality in a matter of just a few months. Think you're not ready? Think again. They are your one-stop shop for mobile application development. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. Or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today. What's up, business rock stars? Are you ready to bring out the CEO in you? Join Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, every other Friday on That Business Show. She'll be talking with other chief entrepreneurial officers about how they grew their businesses. Remember, you could join the conversation at Focus on You Strategies Focus Fridays Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. That's facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. Be the CEO of you. Did you know the biggest challenge business leaders face today is creating an engaged and productive workforce culture? Bill Meyer Ham Consulting wants to help you solve this challenge. They will help you transform your workforce culture to produce amazing business results. Call Bill Meyer Ham Consulting at 941-201-4650 today or visit BillMeyerHam.com. That's BillMeyerHam.com. Have a conversation.
I knew Mom wanted to stay at home. It's the center of her family, her life. But helping Mom stay in her home while managing mine was just too much. Honestly, it wasn't just about me. Mom didn't want me to be her caretaker. She wanted me to be her daughter. I felt so alone until I found out about Home Instead Senior Care. When we met the people at Home Instead, we just knew they were different. The experience was personal. And most importantly, for Mom and me, I get to be her daughter again.
Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vane 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vane 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vane 911 today at 855-VANE-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vane 911. We will help you feel great again.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Good morning. We start off in Pasco County, crash at Little Road and Trinity. Also, we've got a crash in Tampa, Dale Mabry and Columbus Drive. Some minor delays on Hillsborough Avenue near the Veterans Expressway and some delays off the Howard Franklin Bridge from just off the bridge over to West Shore. See traffic problems. Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Uterick, Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Think It Up.
Hi, I'm Nick Jonas, and I'm here to tell you about Think It Up, a new initiative to activate student-powered, teacher-led learning projects. Students and teachers, how can you spark great learning experiences in your classrooms today? Join us at thinkitup.org.
Today, mostly sunny and hot with a high 93, the heat index over 100. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 80. Tomorrow, a 20% rain chance, high 92.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Talking to Bob Johnston, CEO of Front Burner. Learn more at FrontBurnerBrands.com. And they are the parent company of the well-known Melty Pot restaurant brands here, based in the Tampa Bay region. Now, see, you just moved into a new headquarters. And the millennial employees influenced or inspired your new space. How did that come about?
Yeah, that was a great project. And we had a lot of fun with. We engaged our entire team in this, you know, well over a year ago, and kind of imagining what our future home would look like. And we did some really interesting exercises to give everybody an opportunity to talk about what they wanted this to feel like. And then we used a local company here in Tampa, Create and Co. To help us design that space and meet the objectives. And it's a very fun place to work, very comfortable, very open, cutting edge, mm-hmm. a collaborative work environment. We don't have any private offices at all. In fact, I work right next to somebody else.
Is that a millennial concept that we hear so much about, how they're impacting, you know, business and the culture? Are they shying away from the traditional, you know, private office or something in business? Was that one of the things?
I think they enjoy being with each other, and you know, oftentimes Google gets credited for this kind of an environment, you know, but I don't think that they were necessarily the first to come up with that. A lot of the ideas that we utilized, we pulled from a couple of different books that we had studied. The 2020 Office, which kind of talks about who's going to be working for us, and the millennial workforce is hugely important. I mean, here very shortly, they're going to make up 70% of the workforce.
Yep, right? Yeah, we had that discussion a number of times on this program, the impact that they're having on not only the culture, but also the business environment. Now, Front Burner and Melting Pot, based here in the Tampa Bay area, you know, what's on the horizon here with the company? And I see you maybe offering some new services. How's that going to impact your business and also the Tampa Bay community?
Sure. Well, we've been doing a lot of hiring here, and we're really proud to be able to say that we were one of the finalists in Tampa Bay's Business Journal's Best Places to Work, as well as Coolest Office Space, which is, you know, it's an acknowledgement of what we were just talking about, creating an environment that is productive but also fun, you know, a place where our team members don't really want to go home from, and they're eager to come back the next day. So we're pleased with that. As far as our consulting services, you know, what we're doing is helping companies with everything from studying whether or not their concept is franchisable and helping them with a scalability plan, as well as working on assisting with marketing and freight and distribution logistics, which in the restaurant business is hugely important. You know, we have to get our product to all of our locations quickly, efficiently.
So the consulting company is under the Front Burner brand, which is going to, of course, be separate from the Melting Pot restaurants. Now you're going to be advising companies on how to franchise and grow, which you've done an amazing job of. Will you work with companies of all types, or will you work with just restaurateurs under that brand?
We're in two industries. We know the franchise industry dead cold, but we also are in the restaurant business. Mm-hmm. But we can and have helped businesses that are not in the restaurant industry learn how to grow. And along the way, I think that we're going to discover a concept that needs help with growth and put it underneath the Front Burner umbrella, and that'll become our next growth vehicle, adding it to what we're doing with growing the Melting Pot as well. So that's really the game plan, to help businesses learn how to grow and perhaps even partner with them in some way to be a part of that growth.
Well, definitely needed. I always talk a lot about the importance of mentor and protege relationships, and you know, giving back and stuff. And you've got, you know, 30 some plus years of industry growth knowledge here, and so I commend you for giving back to the community through that. It's very important because you know there's so much knowledge out there, you know, to give back.
Well, now, you know, we do that, if you don't mind. You know, one of our melting pot principles is family and belonging. And talks about exactly what you're saying, is giving back to the community that supports us. And one of the ways that we do that is with a partnership with St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. And we've raised over $10 million for St. Jude in our charitable partnership. And for the listeners who are in the Tampa Bay area, I want to tell them about the St. Jude Walk, which is a large fundraiser in this area coming up September 24th, yep, that we're a title sponsor of, the Melting Pot is this year. But even if you're not in the Tampa Bay area, get on St. Jude's website, and they hold walks across the country. And we're real proud of our relationship with St. Jude. And that's our national charity. But here locally in Tampa, we work with Metropolitan Ministries and many other charities. And we think our principles that we talked about in the first segment, you know, guide us to do that. I mean, we feel that's the right responsible thing to do. And our millennial workforce is really interested in being a part of something that matters, that has a sense of purpose. And yep, that's what we're trying to be as an organization.
Thanks. Some good information coming from a very experienced CEO here in studio today. For people, we got about a minute left. For people that aren't familiar with the Melting Pot, give us a quick pitch on what people can expect from it, the ambiance of it, and some of the locations.
Sure. Well, the Melting Pot is a fondue restaurant where you're not only enjoying a meal but being entertained right at your table. And we have 125 locations across the country. If you want to know where they are, visit meltingpot.com, put in your zip code, and the closest location is right there for you.
All right. Good information and some good principles of practice for people out there who have a business and have a little bit of problem expanding. He had the aha moment with his brothers of the problem lied within them. And when they put together those eight principles, the growth of the business took off. So Bob Johnston, CEO of Front Burner, the parent company of the Melting Pot restaurant brand, thank you so much for being in studio this morning.
That's my pleasure. Thanks.
And again, learn more at frontburnerbrands.com. Also want to thank my guests in that 8 o'clock segment again, Josh Vietti, hip hop and pop violinist. Subscribe to his YouTube channel titled Jay Vietti. He's an amazing artist. We heard a couple of his tracks in the 8 o'clock segment, and also you can learn more about him, joshvietti.com. And also thank you to my guest in the 7 o'clock hour. At 7 o'clock, had Carl Gold, author and business growth expert. Good discussion, and an amazing author with a lot of different books out there. Number one best-selling author on Amazon. Learn more, carlgold.com. And also Frank Meekins talking about their upcoming production of Beauty and the Beast, going on from July 29th to August 7th. Pick up tickets for that, newtampaplayers.org. Hope everybody has a great weekend. Tune in again Monday morning at 7 a.m. to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.